90% of Windows have the wrong installation. This is the typical Windows installation scheme. The problem is that it is kinda outdated. It was created when we had normal size and white frame windows. But what do we need today? We need windows from the floor up to the ceiling with black frames. The bigger window frames, the better reputation. First, let me explain the logic behind this scheme. The wedges are usually from plastic. Different sizes and shapes, they are used to support the window, so you need around 2 cm slot to fit them. Wedges below the window needs to be leveled and in a correct location. Window which has an opening feature needs support below the posts, while fixed windows need support below the glass. The distance and amount of wedges depends on the window weight. You can always use more wedges below the window, especially if you have opening door or window and you may step on the frame. On a vertical wedges, simple physics is used. Glass is heavy and when the weight press here, then the frame shifts here and here, like so. So you need support here and here. Temporarily, for fixation and foaming, you need to use wedges here and here also. But after foam glue is dry, you need to remove them. Leaving these wedges here and here is a big mistake. The reason is thermal expansion. The white plastic frame expands up to 1.6 mm per meter and the black frame up to 2.4 mm per meter. So at sunny day, the frame expands and at the night shrinks. That is why you need to leave some playing room. When the frame expands, it will transform from square to rhombus. Causing opening or closing functionality issues. Nowadays it is possible to create a fixing point here and here. So while thermal expansion, the lower and the upper frame moves equally, eliminating the window functionality problems. The easiest way is to use 2 special rods, which you connect to the frame and to the wall, one diagonally to prevent moving this way, and the other across to keep diagonal in place. I will show these rods a bit later when I will speak about exterior installation. The second better way is to use triangle-shaped thick metal sheet with anchors for window frame and the wall. This works best for the timber-framed houses since there is less space for the fixation. Yes, today we are lacking solutions for a proper installation equipment. At least in my country, these rods are sold only in few internet shops and you can't find them in a shop. And this triangle anchor is pretty much do-it-yourself project, which means you need to pay for the quality. Somewhere around 2.2 meters is the maximum height of the plastic frames. For example, I plan to build a house with maximum of 2.1 meter windows, so I have an option to choose from cheap to expensive solutions. Plastic is cheaper and personally I prefer it over timber frames. Timber is more stable and because of that, larger windows have timber frames. Especially timber aluminium frames, where the metal layer protects the frame from the sun heat, decreasing thermal expansion problems. One YouTuber built a house with a 2.5 meter high window slot and he wished windows like this, but turned out that his budget could afford only 3 times cheaper and 10 times uglier plastic windows. Foam glue does not hold the window in place. You need to screw it to the wall. Nowadays there are clamps which support the frame. Old school method where anchors were screwed straight through the frame does not work with big modern plastic frames. Wedges or anchors may press some cracks into the glass. Old windows were small, white and they were not so tight since they played a role in a natural ventilating system. Nowadays good timber frames are made from good wood and have many layers glued together. There are less movements with changing temperature or moisture level, so there should work anchored frame too. thermal expansion movement will destroy the foam sooner or later, and when the foam is cracked, it loses its hermetic features. That is why we have special tapes. They were created to stop the wind. When cold air gets through the foam, it makes interior cheeks cold, and the condensation is easy to come. Some exterior finishings work as a wind stopper. For example, a plastered wall, which has a proper connection to the frame, does not need tape outside, but timber finishings always needs. The windows need to be inside the insulation. If you have stone walls with insulation, then the perfect window location is somewhere here. Windows installed here are cold. Cheeks are cold, causing energy wasting and condensation. With timber walls and wide AAC blocks, which don't need insulation, the perfect placement is also on the outer side. Okay, in the new house, it is easy to install windows in the right spot. But there are many old houses, and maybe the window is already new, but later the house is getting insulation outside. Then yes, maybe it is not worth the investment to remove the windows and install them again. Then they just glue a few centimeters of insulation on the frame, and that may be a good optimization. For example, in my neighborhood, most of the big houses are renovated like so. If you look at this window, then it is deep in the slot, which is ugly, very ugly. But this house is renovated properly. All the windows were changed while the insulating works, plus they don't have here any ventilation holes in the wall or frames, which means that they mounted ventilation pipes to the roof and are using the most energy-efficient ventilation system. Yes, this house may have a big loan, but it will pay back really fast, since the money is burning and heating energy costs more each year, and value of properly renovated house is always good. Our first proper president liked to say, the situation is shit, but shit is a good future fertilizer. So taking a bigger loan for a renovation makes your wallet thinner in the first years, but later it will pay back. Okay, how can we mount the window inside the insulation? The cheapest and shittiest way is to use trusses. So you create the box and install the window as usually with wedges and foam. Here is 20 cm insulation. This truss is 10 cm wide and window frames are usually up to 9 cm wide, which means that the window is not in the middle. A window need to be located at least in the middle of insulation. Plus, the strong and good wood is a bad insulator, so this system is cold. A common mistake is that builders install wet trusses. When they dry, they change shape, and when they are covered with EPS or XPS insulation, then they have trouble with drying, which causes many problems. Especially in modern homes, where the window starts from the floor. Which means that the lower truss is in the foundation area and plinth has usually capillary moisture until hydrostop before the walls. So this lower truss will expand during the rainy season and shrink during the dry weather. There are special brackets for a proper window installation. You drill a hole into the frame, screw bracket into the window frame and connect it to the wall. Use as many brackets as the producer recommends, but don't use them in this area. Leave here around 10 to 15 centimeters. This is because of thermal expansion. The frame expands lengthwise, so a hot, sunny day, the frame has a shape like so. Something like that. So this post expands this direction and this direction, here like so, and so on. And use some special or just longer brackets for diagonals up and down. The standard lower supporting brackets like this have a shitty design. Here is the foundation, here is the floor, and you need to mount the window on the floor. So this window location is too high and you need to find a solution to install it lower. Just buy an L-shaped profile and make a strong and simple bracket by yourself. My future home will have 19 cm concrete wall with 20 cm rock wool insulation and 12 to 12 cm and 1 cm thick steel L-shaped profile. I will cut them around 12 cm wide pieces and each of them will have 2 12 mm wide and 1 10 mm wide holes for a wall fixation. Here I will use 10 mm concrete screw just for a fixation and here I will use M12 3D stick. Since I use hollow concrete blocks which I will fill with the concrete, then I just bend a M12 3D stick to U-shape and place it in position before concrete filling. And it will be tied with rebar, so this way you get strongest and cheapest anchors. The easier but a bit weaker way is to use just anchors for a wall fixation. For a window support I will drill 2 16 mm holes and use M16 treated sticks or bolts. Something similar like on this picture which I got from one of my subscribers. This bolt will be around 10 cm from the wall, which means that the window will be located exactly in the center of insulation. And here I will weld some steel profile which fits nicely with the window profile. On the upper and vertical frames, special brackets. When on the walls I will use 20 cm rock wool, then on the plinth I will use 15 cm EPS. So I will carefully cut EPS and use foam glue where needed. And of course I will use tape here and tape here. On the upper and vertical frames, there are 2 cm gap between the wall and window frame. A 3 cm wide XPS plates will work fine here. These which are used in the bathrooms, since they are stronger. Here, between the frame and XPS, I will have a small gap. And for the finishing, I will use a special profile. Usually, here is used silicone, which will need replacing sooner or later and cracks after some years because of different sort of movements. So using a plastic profile here is long-lasting and beautiful. From the outside, I just cut the wool properly and fit it around the frame. Special profiles will connect the plaster to the frame, so it works as a windstopper. And here I will use a tape. So as you see, then rock wool eliminates the need for a foam glue. And windows which starts higher than the floor don't need the foam glue at all. Okay guys, now I need your comments below the video. You can comment anything you want, but if your head is full of windows at the moment, then one simple question for you. Boobs or bums? Choose your favorite and like other comments too.
And boobs or bums?
Eh?
Boobs or bums?